It is time for all of us to get ready for the return of the Lord. This is the right time now, like never before, to draw closer to Christ. And if you don't have a relationship with Christ, now is a time to get a relationship with Christ, to develop a relationship with the Lord, Jesus Christ, Yeshua. Now is a time like never before, with all that we see around us, the pestilences, the earthquakes, as per the words of Christ in Luke chapter 21, verse 11, great earthquakes and pestilences and fearful sights in the heavens. And we see these signs, and even more so now with this COVID-19 fiasco, and that's precisely what it is. The evil powers that be that control this sick, sin-filled world. They want to control the masses. They are moved by the devil to do these evil things, spreading these viruses and then spreading fear. That's what it's all about. It's to spread fear. Keep in mind, just 2 years ago in the United States, in the winter of 2017-18, so we're looking at about 2 years ago, there were 80,000 deaths caused by the flu. Everything was quiet. There was no lockdown. There was no travel ban or specific amounts of food that you're supposed to buy or limited to. Everything was fine. Nothing was mentioned in the media. Now we have this pandemic, so they call it, to create fear. And people are fearful. There's no fear in love, as per the first epistle written by John chapter 4 verse 18. There's no fear in love, and God is love. In, again, the first epistle written by John chapter 4 verse 8. So there's no fear when you are with God, with the Lord Jesus Christ, Yeshua. There's no fear when you are with Him. This is why I encourage you all to make a stand now like never before. We see these crazy signs going on, these prophetic signs mentioned by the Lord Jesus Christ. But this thing about this pestilence, COVID-19 virus, took everyone off guard, including me. So this is why I urge everyone, for those who know the Lord, to draw closer to Him. Please, draw closer to the Lord like never before. As a brother in the faith, I urge you, please, to draw closer to the Lord. Go on your knees. Close the door of your bedroom. Go to your bedroom. Go on your knees. Extend your hands towards the heavens, as King Solomon did, and pray to the Lord. Make your supplications known to Him. This is serious stuff. The world that we live in is getting darker and darker every day. Spiritual darkness is increasing. What is good is now evil, and what is evil is now considered as good. Because Satan knows, that miserable twit knows all too well, that the number of his days are numbered. He has only a few days left. He's fully aware that the Lord Jesus Christ is going to come back soon. So he is moving his human agents, the Vatican, the Jesuits, the big corporations, the CEOs or the merchants of this world, to work in unison with the Vatican to create this fear, the big organizations, and so on. These guys have tons of money, and they are in bed with the media. The media, let's admit it, is very left-wing. They want to install fear in people, and I'm convinced beyond any doubt that the numbers of deaths related to COVID-19 is not as high as they're reporting. Hospitals will just increase the numbers of COVID-19 related deaths to make an impression on the masses. They want people to live in fear so as to make them believe that this is real. In return, they get government funding. So the more people are dead and those deaths are related to COVID-19, the more these hospitals get funds. Just last week, President Trump announced more funding to the hospitals. What a coincidence. So do not be fooled by this charade. And again, for those who are Christians, those who are followers of Christ, again, I urge you, please draw closer to Christ like never, ever before. This is not the time to be laodicean Christians. This is not the time to be lukewarm or lackadaisical in your approach towards Christ. To those who claim to be Christians, as I said before, pray as often as you can. Fast, if you're able to. Meditate on the Word of God. Draw closer to Christ. And just as important, have the faith of the Lord Jesus or Yeshua and keep His commandments. That is key. The faith of Jesus and keeping the commandments of God are the two prerequisites for being considered as a saint of God, according to Revelation chapter 14, verse 12, my favorite Bible verse. And even then, Paul says in Romans chapter 2, verse 13, that the doers of the law shall be justified. And if you're not a Christian, even if you're an atheist, a Muslim, a Jew, and even those who claim to be Christian but are not really, because they don't show the fruits of being a Christian, whether you be Catholic, Protestant, Orthodox, or even Adventist, please draw closer to Christ like never before. And going back to what I was saying before about atheists, Muslims, and Jews, and Hindus, and so on, I invite you to get to know the Christ of the Bible. As a Christian, as a follower of Christ, I can tell you that the prophecies of the Lord Jesus Christ are all coming to pass. And now, with this fanaticism with COVID-19, I assure you, they want to create fear and they want to control your mind. Do not live in fear. If you are a Muslim, a Jew, a Hindu, or any other religion that does not recognize Jesus Christ as the Son of God or as the Messiah, I encourage you, like never before, to turn to Him. This is not the time to follow religion. This is a time to follow the Lord Jesus Christ, because He is the way, the truth, and the life. Not Muhammad, not Shiva, not anyone else, but Him. Get your act together. Dear Muslims, dear Jews, dear Hindus, even you, atheists, agnostics, stop sitting on the fence. Turn to the Lord Jesus Christ. You will not regret it. Don't turn to religion. Religion is man-made, but embrace the Lord Jesus, Yeshua. Embrace Him. We see more and more Jews becoming Messianic Jews. They realize that the prophecies of the Lord Jesus Christ, Yeshua, are coming to pass. In Matthew chapter 24, along with Luke chapter 21, verse 11, and also verse 25, now is a time like never before to get ready for Christ. But let it be known first that Satan will impersonate Christ. He will come on earth. His feet will touch the earth. Remember that. Satan wants to be worshipped. Okay? Remember that. Isaiah chapter 14, verse 14. Satan hates Jesus. Obviously, we all know that. He hates God. He hates mankind too. So be careful. When you see that father of lies impersonating the Lord Jesus Christ, he will do so through miracles. And everything will look good for a while. But then sudden destruction shall hit them. There will be no peace. 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3. So again, whether you are a Christian or not, get closer to Christ now. This is not fear-mongering. I do not live in fear at all. I don't have the spirit of fear, but of love, of power, and of a sound mind. As per Paul's writings, he mentions that. And that's true. True followers of Christ have the peace of Christ. They have the spirit of love and of power and of a sound mind. And by the power of the Holy Spirit, I urge you now, like ever before, like never before, to turn to the Lord Jesus. Things are not well in this world. The powers that be want to control you. And they're doing so through the media with fear, fear-mongering every day about this COVID-19 fiasco, this scandemic. And what are you going to do? If you don't have the love of Christ in you, you will abide in fear. And we saw the riots. We saw people demonstrating, and they're upset. This will eventually lead to martial law. And I assure you, when martial law will come, whether it be in Canada or especially in the United States, I assure you, your freedoms and your individual rights are finished. Allow me to read you to you Luke chapter 21, verse 36, the words of the Holy Son of the Holy Living God, Yeshua Jesus Christ, the Messiah. Watch ye therefore, and pray always, that ye may be accounted worthy to escape all these things that shall come to pass, and to stand before the Son of Man. Get stubborn for Christ. Get zealous for Christ like never before. Now's the time. You see things are not right, just don't sit and do nothing about it. Draw closer to Christ. And as you know, He is the way, the truth, and the life. Get your act together. Stop living in apostasy. Stop abiding in the commandments of men, in the traditions of men, and abide by the commandments of Christ, Yeshua, Jesus Christ. Now is a time to get right with God. I've said this before in other videos, but now, like never before, I assure you, as God is my witness, now is a time to get right with God. Develop a strong relationship with God if you don't have a relationship with the Lord Jesus or Yeshua. If you don't, start now. As I mentioned before, go inside your bedroom. Go on your knees, raise your hands, holy hands towards the heavens, and let your supplications and your prayers be known to the Lord Jesus Christ, and also to the Father, of course, as per Christ's example in John chapter 17. Pray to God the Father, and always pray when you finish your prayer. Always say thank you, Heavenly Father, in the name of your Holy Son, Jesus Christ, through the Holy Spirit. I urge you, please, now like never before. I keep repeating myself, but I'm serious. Now is the time to get right with God. Things are not well in this world, especially right now. This is not right what I'm seeing right now in this world. This control of the masses is not right. Don't let your mind be controlled by fear, but by the love and the peace of Christ. May the love, peace, and grace of the Most High God be with you in these troubling end times. I love you all. So be it. Amen.